Hi, AMCTO members. My name is Nina Lecic, and for the past year, I've had the privilege to be one of your directors at large on the AMCTO Board of Directors. And in fact, I've enjoyed the experience so much that I'm currently in the running as one of your candidates for the next two-year term to continue being one of your directors at large. So ahead of the voting that's taking place tomorrow on May 27th, which I encourage all of you to vote, I wanted to send a few words. Actually, I thought I was going to be super cool and send you a cool TikTok. I had the app. I couldn't figure out how to use it. I Googled how to use it. Still couldn't figure it out. Deleted it. So here I am. I thought I would stick to what I know and just send a quick video giving you a few words about myself ahead of the voting. So AMCTO has done quite a bit of work this time in highlighting all of the candidates. And if you go on their website, I encourage you to read the profiles of the candidates. Of course, I encourage you to read mine in particular. I talk a lot about myself. I talk about why I joined the board a year ago, why it was important to me. And I talk about my career and my involvement in our industry. So I won't reiterate all of that. I'll just highlight a few quick facts. Of course, my involvement in the board for the past year, it was a challenging year for the world, but I was really honored to be part of the board and part of this really awesome group of people on the board that did their best to assist AMCTO and to lead AMCTO in pivoting throughout the pandemic. I talk about my involvement on committees through volunteer capacities on AMCTO, and I talk about my involvement in the Zone 3 executive. And it was all of those different avenues that gave me opportunities to meet many of you, which was really a highlight for me being on the board. I also talk about my work with several municipalities. I worked from small town Ontario, population 8,000, to currently one of the fastest growing municipalities in Ontario. It's that work with different municipalities that really drew me to be to apply to be your director at large a year ago, because I feel I know the unique challenges and opportunities of the varied different municipal sizes in Ontario. And it's what I think makes me a really good candidate and why I want to continue to represent our membership at large. And lastly, I talk about my passion for my career path, my passion for public service. I'm usually the loudest in the room telling everyone why I love what I do. And the past year representing our incredible membership has really been very valuable to me. So enough about me. If you have any questions, please go read the profile, or if you'd like to chat a little bit more, please reach out to me. But really what I wanted to talk to you about today is why me? And I want to talk about what I would like to do for you over the next 2 years. I've had a chance on the board this year to really learn a lot about AMCTO, learn about its financial background, and learn about its strategic plans and about its goals going forward. So with tremendous respect for its path, here I am with my top three reasons why you should select me so that we could forge a really awesome path together for AMCTO. So here we go. Number one, revenue sustainability. Let's be honest, 2020 was a tough year fiscally for the world. Municipalities and associations like AMCTO did their best to pivot and to remain revenue neutral for the year. I recognize that our programs and our courses through AMCTO are part of our long-term revenue sustainability. To that end, I myself have continued to take all of the various AMCTO courses and programs offered. And I continue to encourage those around me and those that are my friends on LinkedIn to continue taking the courses. In fact, over the last year, I myself was a presenter at one of our free webinars. And just a few days ago, I was a moderator in another webinar of ours. So my promise for the next 2 years is to focus on revenue sustainability to ensure the long-term longevity of AMCTO for all of its members. Number two, policy and legislative engagement. So we know from our survey to you members, we know that a lot of you, like 70% of you, look to AMCTO and its membership for its policy and legislative advocacy. We know that you look to AMCTO to represent you and to provide you with the most up-to-date policy and legislative updates. To that extent, as part of the board for the past year, we've had the unique ability to comment on and to provide advocacy on any legislative changes. And for the next 2 years, I promise to make that a priority because I know it's a priority to you. In fact, today I'm joining a few of my fellow board members in a meeting with the minister where we will talk about advocacy on code of conduct changes. I'm totally playing it cool, but this is my first meeting with a minister on advocacy changes, so it's kind of a big deal. And last but not least, longevity. We know that a large part of you is set to retire over the next 5 years, but we also know that the next large part of our members are here to stay for the long run. We're here for the next 20 years and above. And I really wanna make sure that AMCTO sets itself up for longevity with our long-term members. We know our young members coming in are highly educated. We know that they're looking for a lot more out of their memberships and a lot more value out of AMCTO. And what I promise to do is I promise to really be that voice for our next generation and that voice for all of our memberships so that AMCTO will be a value for all of us. So from engagement with post-secondary education to vouching for the next generation, I promise to make that a priority. So that's it. That's my three-step promise to you. And I hope you enjoyed this quick video. I hope this wasn't too much of your time. And I encourage all of you to vote. Voting starts tomorrow. And if you have any questions, if you would like to chat, please send me an email or please reach out to me on LinkedIn. I would love an opportunity to meet and to chat. So thank you so much. Have a great day. Bye.